This is going to be the one here before, and just a quick announcement to let you all know that at the end of this show, there's a very cool opportunity to come and take your own photo with one of our sea lions. If you do want to do this, give us some lovely friends, Kate and Connor, up at the back there in the next couple of minutes before the show starts, because we do only have two or three spaces left for after today's show. So once again, if you do want to take your own photo, you're more than welcome to take a set of selfies as well with one of our sea lions. Go and see Kate and Connor up at the back there, and they'll be more than happy to sort that out for you. Make a lovely, lovely photo. We're going to be using our big sea lion today. Claude's going to be doing it, so it makes it even better photo, in my opinion. So once again, if you do want to go take a picture with him, go and see Kate and Connor up at the back there, and they'll be more than happy to put you a place on that, but there's not many left, so go get it quick. But thank you very much for listening, and the show will start in just under 5 minutes' time.
One minute until the show starts, guys.
It will be
soon. Right, guys. I'll see you when the show starts, okay? Show starts.
So far, and
Claude and Ricky.
We're going to have a go doing a show for you. We're going to start by telling you the most important thing about Claude and Reggie here, because the most important thing about them is that they are not seals, what are they?
Sea lions.
Now, oh hello.
Oh no!
That's the leader, she's very new, so we'll just see how she gets on. Now, start by telling you some of the ways you can tell the difference between seals and sea lions. First way is by looking at the flippers on the front of the animal's body. You can see Claude and Reggie. Claude, are you doing this well? I've got very big front flippers. Now, seals don't have that. Let me just show you what seals have got. So, you're going to come around here with me. Seals have got tiny heel flippers. Look. Outside of a human hand. So not very big. Do another one. They're not very strong. And therefore, the whole animal, if you're a seal, is not very agile when it's out of water. But now another way, sea lions are often called eared seals, so seals with ears. And if you look at the sides of their heads, you can see they've got tiny little external ear flaps there. Very small, but they are there, perfect for selective hearing, and make them look a little bit like Shrek. But again, seals like Selena don't have that either. They've only got holes on the side of their heads that are normally covered up by fur, so you can never see a seal's ears. Maybe the best way, though, to tell the difference between a seal and a sea lion is how they walk about on the land. So we're going to get Claude down to start with and do some sea lion walking. Then we'll see if Selena wants to do something after that. Alright, this is how sea lion walks. Look, they walk on four flippers like a dog or a cat walks on four legs. That's because they've got a very similar bone structure to a dog or cat. So similar, they can even do roly-polies. So let's do five. Another one, two, three, four. Pick up on the last one. Five, well done. Seal, we can show you what seals do. So Selena, you're going to spring into action in a second. Look how she gets excited when it's her bit. Alright, come out here. Oh, she's not going to get excited today. She's just going to drift. Alright, so look, seals, turn around. Long, long on their belly. Like they can go very fast if they know they're getting something for doing it, which Selena is going to do. She's going to get some sprat. And another thing that Selena is really good at, it's doing rollovers, so we'll see if we can do three of those. So get ready, here we go. Ready? One! Another one, two. Pick up on the last one. Oh, we're not going to get a last one. Are you going to do another rollover for me? They'll clap for you. There you go.
Yay!
Aww. Another free one. Another one, yeah. Oh, saw something on halfway round. Got stuck. Well done, Selena. Right, you better... Oh. You can get back in the pool now, that's your skill base pretty much exhausted, so let's move on to the sea lion. And we're going to show you some more interesting stuff about sea lions. Claude is going to come down the front and have a close look at the audience. So you're going over
right,
there.
Right, we're looking up, right. Oh, look, look out! Yeah.
Everybody knows sea lions eat fish. If you're a sea lion, you have to be unlucky enough to have to survive in the wild. That means you've got to catch your own. So to do that, they've got a few features about. The first one, very important feature they've got,
Look
he's
at
whiskers.
It.
Have you looked at the front of their noses?
Your
mum. He's got lots of whiskers on there. Every sea lion has got between 40 and 60 whiskers. Every one of them has got 1,800 nerve endings on it. So very, very sensitive. Now, they're so sensitive that even if a sea lion was totally blind in the wild, they'd still be able to find their food by feeling for the movement fish make and then swim about in the water. And now, another way, maybe an obvious way for a lot of people, is teeth. So say, ah, oh, let's have a look at your teeth. Here we go. We'll bring the corner around the other side in a minute so you can all have a look. But you can see the bigger ones at the front. Altogether, they've got 34. A very big sea lion might have 36, but only pointy ones for catching and grabbing. They don't chew the food. They're like dogs and children. So if George throws a few bits of food at Claude, you can see it doesn't touch the side at all. So no chewing at all. And maybe the most important feature is eyesight. They've got the same sort of eyesight that people have. That's called binocular vision. So that means two forward-facing eyes. They can judge speed and distance very, very well. Or should be able to. So we're going to test this by throwing these five hoops I've got here. George has got five as well over there. Over the sea lion's head. Now, there's a lot of people in the audience. Everybody knows how to count up to five, I hope. So we're going to do this together.
Are we ready?
So Richie's going in the pool.
Hold up.
George, are you ready? Are you ready? Okay, good. Is everybody else ready?
Yeah!
Alright, here we go. Red, here we go. Count together. One! Another one. Two! Three!
Right.
Four! Difficult one for the last one. Here we go. Five. Well done. Don't do the thing that is named after them. Okay, now one thing people always like to ask at the end of this show is how do you teach him to do all that stuff? So I will show you quickly. And what I've got here, let's just show you, is a target stick. So all it is a stick with a different colour on the end, so you can see that's blue. Nice and easy to see. They're trained to follow the coloured end with their nose wherever you move it, so you can guide them through more or less any movement that you want them to do. So we'll show you with Reggie to start with. You can see Reggie is very interested in the end of that stick. That's because he knows he gets rewards, or food, or whatever. Every time he touches it, follows it, anything to do with the stick, he gets food for all the while. Because felines are particularly greedy. Oh, I've dropped that. You can pick that up. Because felines are particularly greedy, very easy to get to do stuff if they know there's food about. So look, we can go a step further if you want to kiss each other with the target in the middle. They like doing that, that's quite nice and easy. Richie, come with me! So we can follow a target, or we can go to a target far away. I thought we'd go onto the deck, because he's not used to going onto the deck, so we'll have to make him think for a second. Alright, so trundle all the way up here, you can see his little brain is going, he knows what to do. We can do an impression of Selena, in case Selena can't be bothered to come out of the show, which is a common problem at this place. We can do standing up, that's quite good as well. And another thing you can do with a feline, not with a seal though, is a handstand. So if you want to do a handstand, what you would do is put the target, the guy in front of him like this, lean forward, gradually, and get lift their thumbs up. Until you get a nice handstand like that one. Welcome aboard, and welcome Reggie. And it works exactly the same with a seal. So we're not going to leave Selena out. We'll get her to do something. Ah, now we're a little bit interested, aren't we? Look at the foam. So look, they follow it exactly the same. She knows what to do. But what I'm really going to show you with her is a high jump. Because if you want to do a high jump, obviously all you'll do is put the target above the water like that. She'll swim to the bottom like she's doing now. And if we're lucky, she won't get lost and will do a nice big jump for us. Like that one. You can give her a proper clap for that, you know. But you don't have to get them to follow the target with their nose, you can get them to focus on it with any part of their body. So we'll show you something new that Claude has been learning. So Claude, you're going to come over here with me to this side. Because Claude has been learning to swim over to this side of the pool where I am here, jump out, and hit this blue ball we've got. Not with his nose, because every sea lion can do that, and that is boring and easy, and you can see that anywhere. He's going to hit it with his tail, which is a lot more difficult, isn't it? Yeah. Right, so you are going to go for a run-up for me on that side over there. Try and keep out of the way of Selena. You've got a camera, point it on the blue ball. You're going to have to be very quick at this one, because it's a very, very fast thing to do.
You're right.
Sounds really weird. Is it normal? Yeah? Okay. Just all funny. Come on, go for a proper run up. Alright, so everybody watching the blue ball.
You're right.
Here
we
go.
Watch. Hey!
Hey! That was okay. That was about 6 to 5 minutes of learning for, wasn't it? Alright, now another thing that everybody expects to see for the Sealion Show is to prevent the not to forget anything, which I have done. So let's have some volunteers. Well done for reminding me, George. Is Keegan here, who is 8, and it's her birthday? Yes. Okay, I don't know exactly who you are, but come and stand down here. George is bringing a hoop to you, because we're going to get Claude to swim around the pool and jump through all the hoops. And I need 2 more volunteers. Okay, green shirt on the end. Go and see Kate. And someone has a big cat with a whitish pinkish shirt. Come to the middle with Connor. He'll show you what to do. Because we're going to get Claude to swim all the way around the pool and jump through these hoops. Now hang fire on your hoops dangling over the edge for a minute, because Selena is in this show. We know what happens if Selena sees them. Okay, now volunteers, listen to me. You're going to have to listen very carefully, because Claude, like me, does not do this show right every time. Sometimes, instead of jumping through, what he does, he grabs hold of the hoop on the way round. Are you listening? And tries to pull it in. So if he grabs on, let go, alright? Because we don't have anybody in the water, do we, Claude? No. Alright. Thought you might do that. Now the whole audience can encourage Claude to behave on this. Because on the first hoop, when he jumps through, everybody claps. Second one, everybody stamp. On the one over there, everybody screaming. On the last one, when he jumps through the blue hoop in the middle with me, I want everybody to clap down, scream and shout so loud the whole park can hear you. So, at the ready. We all know what we're doing. Is everybody ready? Yay, you can do better than that, are you sure? Yay! Come on, down you come. Off you go. Alright, so there's one. And then we're two.
Just
are you ready?
Don't worry.
Well, you can do a lot better than that. thing to show you. There's going to be some somersaults in the middle of the pool. Claude is going to do them for us.
Hey,
we're going to have one here, one in the middle, and another one on that part over there. So if you've got a camera, 1, 2, 3, that's where you need to point it. For Claude, you know what to do, so up you go. Thank you very much for coming. And enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you. Bye-bye.